Honey, and today we are going to be talking about my March favorites, and nobody really cares about that anymore because it's the 10th of April, but still, I spend all March taking a Sharpie and writing down things that I love, so I thought we'd talk about it anyway. Also, I'm a malanky bit dehydrated today, so anytime you guys can remember to remind me to take a sip of water, I'd certainly appreciate that. I'm trying to be healthy. The new beginning starts today, and by new beginning, I mean I'm still going to be as unhealthy as I always am. I'm just trying today. Help me. Always wishing for a better tomorrow. March was a super cool, awesome month. Why? Because I got to see you guys three times last month. Was it three? Was it just two? No, it was only two. For some reason in my mind, it seems like three. I wish it would have been three, but sadly, it was only two. Thank you guys so, so much to everyone who came and hung out with me at my South by Southwest meet and greet and at my BeautyCon Dallas meet and greet. And I hope you guys who came and who visited and who hung out with me had as awesome and a memorable time as I did meeting you guys. I'm excited because I'm planning up like three or four other meet and greets this year. So if you didn't get to catch me in the month of March, I know there will be opportunities in the future. First monthly favorite actually was given to me by a Swamp family member in Dallas. And it's one of those low-key bracelets. How do you say this? I don't know. Don't really care. This one is a camouflage one, and it looks like magical little bubbles. And supposedly it's like some sort of reminder, like the white stuff is supposed to come from some mountain way up high and the black bead comes from the lowest point on earth. I don't know, there's supposed to be stuff injected up in here and there's like some discussion about whether there's anything inside the bracelet or not. I don't really care. I don't care if anything's in it. They can fill it with mummy farts and butterfly wings. I will just tell you guys that this has been great on days when I am feeling a little bit panicky or a little bit anxious. The white bead and the black bead on here are extra squishy and I will find myself in times of distress squeezing on these extra squishy beads. I love how it looks. I love how it feels. It is a magical experience. It's a magical experience, like going to Disney World. What really makes it so special is a Swamp family member gave it to me, and I just love wearing it as a reminder of you guys. And thank you that it's camo. It's my favorite color in life. All the good things. Speaking of camo, I have mostly all my other favorites in this camouflage bag, which is yet another monthly favorite. And this was sent to me by Tarte. They were doing like some sort of new product mailer for their concealers. And as part of that, like this came with it. Get it? Camouflage concealer. But it's a Herschel bag. I don't know if you can buy it. I'd imagine that you can. But this is a really awesome, sturdy, canvasy makeup bag. How would it be if I just did like a month of monthly favorites where everything was camo colored? That is exactly something that I would do. Up first is an item that you guys already saw. I think that this was in my purse video, my purse unboxing video, because normally these things are floating around in my bag. I pretty much take them everywhere with me. They are the Tatcha oil blotting sheets, and for me, they seem to work better than any other oil blotting sheet. They are a thin little piper, and they actually have real flecks of actual gold. I said actually and actual in one sentence. Way to go, English major. I think it's rice paper, but the fact that they are more of a paper instead of a plastic, like the blue traditional oil blotting sheets, I feel like on days when I'm wearing my makeup and I want to blot the oil off of my face, that this material displaces my makeup less. I don't feel like I'm rubbing my makeup off. And I also just feel like these do a really good job. I love them, and I feel like I'm almost out, and that makes me cry. Rainbows. Did you remind me to take a sip of water? I felt like I heard somebody out there saying, take a sip of water. Thank you. Next monthly favorite is this shampoo bar, and mine looks totally disgusting now because I've almost run out because I've almost used it all. This is new from Lush, and it has cinnamon in it, and I know many of you are thinking, but Bunny, aren't you allergic to cinnamon? No, I'm only allergic to artificial cinnamon, like cinnamon-flavored gum, cinnamon Tic Tacs, all that kind of stuff, no good, but real, actual cinnamon from planet Earth does me just fine. This stuff smells amazing. It makes my hair look so voluminous and magical, and I swear I feel like I have more little baby hairs sprouting out of my head, because the true purpose of this bar is to promote new hair growth. But the cinnamon is just so invigorating. I feel like it wakes me up if I'm kind of feeling a little bit sluggish. I know that I have recommended several Lush shampoo bars to you guys before. This is my favorite type of shampoo on planet Earth. I just love shampoo bars. This is my new favorite. Next monthly favorite are these lashes from the Vegas Nay Allure collection. I had so many like events and stuff this month to do, and I really just wanted to add that extra va-va-voom to my eyeballs, and I felt like wearing fake eyelashes a lot this month. Oh, I do! I do have a used set from the last time I wore these, but I literally have so many empty boxes of these laying around. I literally made a run to Ulta and I bought every single pair of these that they had left, and I'm about to go do that again. These are the Easy Elegance style, so they add just a little bit of extra drama. They are so lightweight, they are so wispy. They're like if your lashes just get kissed by angels, and they add just a little bit of volume. That is what we are dealing with here. I have very sensitive eyes, as I'm sure I've said. I feel like that guy in the contact lens commercial where I'm like, eyelashes for my special eyes. If you just want to add a little bit of drama, but you don't want anything that you're going to feel, that you're going to notice that you have on, that's going to add weight, make your eyes feel tired, these lashes are amazing, and they're so affordable. They are like a drugstore item. You can find them at Target, you can find them at Ulta. I'm not sure if real drugstores sell them, because I have a just hellfire avoidance of drugstores, but that is the price range that they are in, and Naomi is just a wonderful, beautiful person inside and out. I love her to death. Next thing on the list is two different sunscreen creams. We are getting into summertime in Texas, which means everybody's skin's gonna burn off. One is from Tatcha. This is the Silken Pore Perfecting Sunscreen. It has SPF 35 in it. You really do get a nice generous amount in this tube. I generally grab this product on days when I know that I'm not really going to be putting on makeup, but I still want skincare and I still want to be protected from the sun. This one feels very moisturizing. It's like a moisturizing cream with sunscreen in it. I cannot get over the smell. It smells so delightful. It still does have that delicious sunscreen smell, but with a little bit of citrus in it as well. It has like wild rose and loquat leaf and silk extract. It's supposed to make your skin look bright and beautiful, and I feel like it's working. I feel like I've used a considerable amount of this tube up in a month. I feel like about that much is gone already, and I have to really like something to like pick it up day in and day out. The other one that I was showing you guys, I've actually been going through this travel size one quite a bit, but this is the Invisiblur Perfecting Shield by Murad, and this is SPF 30. This stuff literally makes your skin look photoshopped in real life. Sometimes I do wear this alone, but I also apply this on days when I want sunscreen, but also when I'm going to want like a perfected, poreless kind of makeup look. This was actually in my Sephora play box this month. It looks like it is a clear gel, and you just rub it in and it feels like you're rubbing buttery clouds in on your skin. When you apply it, you can literally just instantly tell a difference that your face looks poreless. Next, I have two different foundation-y kind of products. One is for, once again, when I'm doing a full face of makeup, and one is for lighter, fresher, more natural makeup days. The first one is the new Naked Skin One and Done, and I just noticed that this has sunscreen in it too. So the theme of this video today is camo and sunscreen. This is a new hybrid complexion perfector. I think maybe a lot of people would wear this as a CC kind of product, a complexion corrector type thing. It is so lightweight. It is so easy to blend. And I actually gave away the lightest shade, which was light, to a friend. I thought this one suited my skin a little bit better. This is the shade medium light. It's just so easy to apply. It's in a tube, but it comes with a pump. I love that. Every time that I have worn this in a video, I just get so many compliments from you guys on my skin, on my complexion. Now that I'm rubbing this in, I think maybe light might suit me better. I don't know. Light, when I swatched it, looked really more yellow than what I needed. I think that this is the one with the neutral or pink undertones, but you really do get a lot of coverage out of this product. I can literally wear it all day and it never feels like it's moving or displacing or making me look oily and messy. It does look a little off coloring wise for me. Days that I've been wearing this, nobody has been commenting that my makeup doesn't look right. So I think once I blend it out and do a full face of makeup and kind of mix it up with some moisturizer, the tone becomes better matched to my skin. It's a product where really I think they only have 4 or 5 different colors to choose from. So it's kind of just like pick the best one that matches you. You know what I mean? Next product you guys have seen several times this month is the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Foundation. This stuff, it's all in the name. It is pure magic. Days when I wear this, I literally do look mannequin-y, Photoshop in real life. It covers all imperfections. It's a demi matte foundation, so it never looks too cakey. It also never looks too dewy. It's literally perfect right there in the middle. I am in the shade Fair 2. Once again, sometimes I feel like when I wear this and I just have foundation on, people are apt to kind of tell me like, oh, that doesn't match your skin color. This is the color that they actually matched me to in Nordstrom, so there it is on my arm, swatched in the worst place possible. I like for my foundation to be kind of light. I feel like then it brightens my face. This, I think, is only sold in Nordstrom's. I really wish Sephora or Ulta would start carrying this brand. It's absolutely amazing. I'm wanting to try more products from the Charlotte Tilbury range. But if you ever go somewhere and you can get a sample of it, I encourage you guys to at least try a sample of this product. I feel like it will change your foundation life. Speaking of Charlotte Tilbury, I also finally got the Bar of Gold highlighter. I had seen it so many times on the internet, just on Instagram over and over again. The packaging is absolutely adorable. I feel kind of sad because it looks less like a bar of gold now. It had a stamp on it. You can still kind of see it where it was like 9.99 pure gold. So cute. I have never gotten so many compliments on any other makeup product, like personally in real life, than on the days that I wear this. Everybody is always like, oh my God, what's that on your face? What is that highlighter? It is just so incredibly beautiful. It is so bright, and just swatching it does not even do it justice. Just any of the pictures, any of the videos that you guys have seen this past month from me, I have been wearing this highlighter. Somehow every swatch that I do is slightly worse than the one that I did previous. How am I still so bad at life? So many years on YouTube later. I don't know. I wore this to BeautyCon and I literally, so many of you guys were so sweet and I was getting so many compliments on my highlighter. You have got to try it if you get the chance. I don't even remember how much it was, but I feel like it's worth every single penny. Moving right along, and I can't even believe I wrote this down. I wrote down Butu Blender. What is that? What is the Butu Blender? I tried the new Beauty Blender Nude. I think it's called Nude. It reminds me of like an antique photograph. It's got like a sepia filter on it. You guys know that Beauty Blender is like my indispensable makeup application tool. If I was going to recommend a color of Beauty Blender to you guys, I would definitely recommend trying this one. If you don't have one yet, or if you're in need of a new one, I feel like every time I clean this, I've probably used this one 20 times already. And I feel like since there's no dye or kind of coloration in it, I'm able to clean it a lot better and I don't feel like it's losing dye. I feel like the lighter colored ones, like I have the white one, the pink one, and this one, and for me, I feel like somehow I'm able to put product on better with the lighter colored ones than the ones that are like black or red. I think it's only been out for a couple of months, but for some reason I feel like the lighter colors apply my makeup better somehow. It's maybe just a power of suggestion. I don't know what's going on. I also feel like I can get these sponges cleaner. I really feel like I'm just able to kind of see where the dirt and the product is and clean it out more, if that makes any sense. I keep wanting to make a routine of how I clean my Beauty Blenders. Thumbs up if you guys are interested in seeing that. I know a lot of people have difficulty cleaning them properly or just like questions about it. So I can show you guys how I get mine in brand new, perfectly clean condition. If y'all are curious about that, let me know. Whenever I have them all clean, this is always the one that I end up grabbing over all the others. And I'm just like excited. I'm like, oh, that one's clean today. I'm gonna go for that one. Up next, I have some music and movie and television, which sort of like Netflix-y recommendations for you guys. First of all is music. Animal Collective recently released a brand new album. They are one of my favorite bands ever. Their album is called Painting With. I think it's got like 13 or so tracks. I honestly, oh my gosh, and my phone is at 4% battery because I like to take a walk on the wild side. I have probably listened to that album 40 or 50 times and I'm not even exaggerating. It's just every time I get in my car, I'm constantly putting on that album. Next is a movie favorite. It's not on Netflix yet. Dogman and I bought it on iTunes. It is from M. Night Shyamalan and I mentioned it already and it's called The Visit. I know some people didn't like it. Some people were not thrilled about it, but it is honestly my favorite movie that I've seen in a long time. It's a movie that I would like to definitely watch over and over again. It's suspenseful, it's creepy. If you're somebody that likes like really gory, shocking, like disturbing kind of horror movies, then you're probably not gonna like this because this is more like a throwback. It's more like suspenseful, creepy. It just gives you like the heebie-jeebies, but I loved it. It's got like some twists in it and it's just a really good movie. If you like creepy movies, I think that you will like it also. My next favorite is actually, it's a documentary that was on CNN. Doesn't that sound fun? But Tom Hanks did it or made it or produced it, and like if Tom Hanks literally spits, you just know it's gonna be a good thing, right? Tom Hanks spitting. That's what I want to watch. It is a documentary series and they just now released it on Netflix. Dogman and I actually started watching it when we were in Austin shooting things for my BeautyCon box and we were just flipping through the channels on the hotel and we landed on CNN and they were playing this documentary. It's like 6 or 8 different episodes and it's all about different stuff in the 60s. It's just so like interesting and immersive and there are some episodes that discuss like disturbing things like social conflicts, war, stuff like that. So some of the episodes can be triggering or bothersome, but I just really think that like if you want to learn some different things about history, like that is a really kind of like informative, interesting way to expand your knowledge, expand your mind, learn some things. And they have interviews from people who were actually like involved in all of the stuff, you know, activists, artists, musicians. It's really, really interesting. And something about it is also like calming. Like they have episodes like about the Beatles and about like British invasion and about kind of like culture-y stuff like that. And those episodes for me are just like really calming. But there's a couple of them I haven't watched yet because some of them I think like might be kind of like, ugh, like disturbing. So I haven't watched some of them yet, but the ones that I have watched are just so good. I think they're like an hour and 20 minutes a piece. They also have one on the 70s and we haven't watched that one yet, but they're on Netflix now. So it's kind of like a free thing to just see if you like, if you already have Netflix. I think that's it. I feel like that's everything. Once again, a super long video every single time. I would love to make brief videos, just don't know how. Thank you guys so much for being here today, for hanging out. I hope y'all had an awesome March. I hope you're even gonna have a more awesome April, and we are about to be in summertime time, and won't that be a magical time for everybody? Thank you guys so much for being here today, for watching and for hanging out with me. If you're not already and you'd like to be, hit that button down below, subscribe, become a member of the Swamp Family, and give an alligator its wings. Also, if you want, you can like me on Facebook, facebook.com/graveyardgirl, or you can follow me on Twitter, Tumblr, or Instagram at graveyardgirl, same way it's spelled here. I love you guys so much, and I will see y'all tomorrow. Bye!